Well, hello everyone. This is Therese Santos, your presidential director with LifeWave. And today is day six of Patch School. And it is all about one of my favorite subjects, and that is improving the quality of your sleep. We're going to be spending our time today talking about silent night patches. And I'm going to be sharing with you some tips that you might not know about sleep in general and how the silent night patches can actually support you, someone you love, clients, patients. Let's go ahead and talk all about sleep. So I have a question for you. How is your sleep life? Really? How is it? Are you getting the deep quality sleep that you know you need, especially in times of stress? Are you dreaming? Did you know that if you're not dreaming, your sleep could actually be far better? Dreaming is a part of the whole process. You got to dream and go through that theta state in order to get to that deep delta state. So another question for you. Are you waking up in the middle of the night, especially between the hours of 1 a.m. and 3 a.m.? If the answer is yes, your sleep could be better. And so sleep is a really personal subject for me. If it wasn't for my history with sleep challenges, insomnia for almost 10 years, I wouldn't have been interested in LifeWave. It was my own sleep issues that brought me to LifeWave. And it was the notorious silent night patches that actually changed my own sleep life. And honestly, it changed my life. And so 2.5 years later, I continue to be so, so happy. It's probably been one of the best yeses I've ever made in my life, just saying yes to LifeWave and just being open to something that I wasn't familiar with. So, all right, let's get right into a silent night. I'm going to give some really good information that you can use right now and also put it into your patch, what we've been calling your patches toolbox. As you are hearing people say and talk about, whether it's been sleep or stress or pain or whatever it is, we have a patch that can certainly support people. I also want to ask a question. I believe it was Patch School Day 2 when we talked all about EON, our broad spectrum anti-stress patch, anti-inflammatory patch. And oftentimes, if I'm speaking on a stage, I will ask the audience this question. And I haven't brought this question up or brought this question to Patch School yet. So hear me out. You might even want to jot this down, and you're welcome to borrow this. And that is, when is the last time you ever saw a highly stressed individual or a person struggling with sleep and thought to yourself, wow, they look amazing? Probably never. Because stress and sleep, boy, they compromise health, beauty, increase aging, increase pain. So it is so important. You can't even have a conversation around self-healing if you're not first addressing sleep issues and stress issues. And so silent night patches are a patented technology that improves cell communication. It is again What we are doing is using the body's acupuncture system instead of the nervous system to communicate. We know the acupuncture system, by now, if you've been with me, the acupuncture system is 200 times faster than the nervous system. That's why the life wave technology, the light therapy patches, when placed on specific acupoints, work so much faster. And wouldn't we, it just makes sense. Why would somebody not want to have more natural, holistic, faster results? So it is all about just making sure that we understand the life wave technology is really ancient Chinese medicine. It's acupuncture without the needles. It's really ancient wisdom that meets modern day technology, the life wave technology. And so here's where we are going to start. So now that I've asked you about your sleep life, now that we've talked about, you know, if you're not dreaming, that's a big opportunity to improve your sleep life. And when you improve your sleep life, everything else about your health and wellness, everything about your life improves. That's just energy in general. When we improve our energy, we improve our life. I want you to really connect with that. When we improve our energy, we improve our life. And that means we can support others, improve their energy, therefore making life better for them. Did you know that the quality of your sleep is highly connected with the health of your heart? And so anyone that you know that maybe has had some heart complications, some heart issues, I talked all about carnosine yesterday. We certainly will be talking about ETS-39 toward the end of patch school. But I need you to understand that the heart-brain connection is literally, there is such a thing as a connection. And I'm going to go ahead and post a little post in this Facebook group about what that is all about. I really want you to make a note to take a look at that. I also want you to know that there's a powerful meridian point that I'm going to teach you today that you can use yourself, or you can share with somebody that maybe has had open heart surgery. Maybe they have had some heart concerns in the past. Maybe their sleep is really compromised. They've got disturbed sleep because they've had heart concerns or they've had some heart challenges. And I'll be teaching you about that. I'm going to also speak to you and teach you how to handle waking up in the middle of the night. So there is a very active organ in our body that is really active between the hours of 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. And it's our liver. Remember, our liver, according to Eastern medicine, is our body's battery. And so our liver is most active between the time of 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. So for those of you that are waking up around that time, I have a solution for you. And I'm going to get to that right now. There are, with our silent night patches, and I'm going to back it up to kind of talk a little bit more about other benefits of silent night. But this is such a vital one. This is what I hear people talking about very often, is their compromised sleep. They're waking up and then they're not falling back to sleep. That was me. So with the silent night, just like every other patches, they come with their own protocol book. Again, those acupoints that are in the silent night booklet have been clinically tested to create, you know, really substantial results. So, along with this little remedy for waking up between 1 and 3, write this down. Did you know that of those 5 acupoints featured in the Silent Night brochure, 50% of people who use our patches will actually have a great result when they patch the upper body, and the other 50% will have a great result, or maybe a better result, if they patch the lower body. And so liver. So for those of you, and I said that so I could say this, for those of you that know anyone or have the concern with this waking up between 1 and 3 a.m., when again, the liver is the most active, you're going to want to use the silent night patch on the liver 3 point, which, see, silent night, by the way, is a positive patch, which means it goes either on the center of the body or on the right side of the body. And in the booklet, there is a protocol, an acupoint that they show on top of the foot. That's the liver 3 point. And so an incredible remedy solution, where if there were if an acupuncturist or an acupuncture doctor were actually needling, they would needle the liver 3 point. So I'm not going to bring my foot up, but if this was my foot, the liver 3 point is between the first toe or the big toe and the first toe. It's in that web right there at that where you move up into the web. It's where you actually feel like that little tender spot. So again, on the foot is at the liver 3 point. Apply the silent night patch there. And again, try it for a couple days. It's so important that you also teach this. Try a specific acupoint for a couple days before somebody actually decides whether or not this works for them or not. And so in your notes, if there is that waking up, you want to understand it's because that's when our body's battery, the liver, is actually the most active, and patching on that liver point should really be a powerful solution for that. So the next thing I want you to know is that if somebody has some heart concerns, there is a powerful heart meridian point. And again, it would be on your right wrist. And the wrist area is that pericardium area. And so again, this is connected to heart concerns and sleep issues because of heart. So you would literally just follow your pinky down right to that where the wrist would bend. And that would be a powerful acupoint, upper body, right hand. Follow your right pinky down to right where the wrist bends, and you can place a silent night patch there. Very supportive for people that have some heart issues and are having a hard time sleep because of that. The other thing I want to speak to, this is just bottom line benefit, need to know about the silent night patches. What we are doing here is we are not making people drowsy. This is not a sleep aid. This is not a drug that drugs people to sleep. This is not anything like that. This is using, again, light therapy on specific acupoints. Let me share this with you. You can count on when people are using their silent night patches, they're increasing their quality of sleep up to 66%. That's huge. Think about that. It is so substantial. And again, the word that you want to really circle here is quality of sleep. Imagine how that could change someone's life if they're actually sleeping longer and getting better quality of sleep. So again, this doesn't make people drowsy. That's important for you to know. If somebody has sleep issues, which is about 58% of all adults, and sleep issues today are actually considered one of the highest health concerns today. We've got to help people sleep naturally, holistically. Sleep prescriptions are bad news. They're unhealthy. They're unsafe. And if you are working with someone that has been taking prescription medications, I want you to understand that, I am not a doctor. I don't have a healthcare background. I have lots of experience helping people change their sleep life. And what I would recommend is if somebody's been taking, you know, the Ambiens, the over-the-counter dosing of sleep medication, I would say don't have them quit cold turkey. Have them self-wean, and they can use the patches at the same time. Be aware that it could take them just a little longer, but encourage them. Their long-term health is so worth it. Things like these prescription medications have been linked to some very, very, very concerning long-term. There's long-term damage that happens. There's cognitive health. There's brain impairment that happens because of these over-the-counter big bad pharmaceuticals for sleep. And did you know that, you know, even the more natural ones like the melatonin and the herbal type, even though they're better, they will work for a short amount of time and then they don't. And that's because the melatonin, our body's own sleep aid, our body's own anti-aging hormone called melatonin, is actually produced in our pineal gland. Write that one down, pineal gland. That's another one to do a little bit of research on, because once you learn about the pineal gland, you're going to find that there's so much that it's very interesting. And it's, again, it's a better way to, serve yourself and to be more aware of how you can support others. But the silent night patches, unlike any third party product that you might take in, this actually doesn't stop our body from producing it like third party. So anytime you're taking any third party product over the counter or something you think is more natural and helpful, it will work for a short time and then it won't. It will require more, higher dosages. And because why? It stops your body's own ability to create it. In this case, the melatonin naturally. Unlike the silent night, which using light on that specific acupoint is what sends the message to our pineal gland to make its own melatonin, to secrete its own sleep aid. Our body has its own sleep intelligence. And so 66% improvement doesn't make you drowsy. Understanding that one of those five acupoints will work. Now you understand why waking up between 1 and 3 often happens to people. You know that extra point that I spoke about that isn't in the brochure or the booklet has to do with heart, the heart point there. And I believe, as I look down at my notes here, that will do it for today. And now I want to go ahead and just allow any questions that you might have here for me, for those of you that are with me live, knowing that these are recorded and most people are catching these on the playback. However, the advantage of joining me live is you get to share or you get to ask a question. So at this point, please feel free to chime in and comment. How are you? For those of you that are with me today, have you had a good result with Silent Night? Do you have a question about Silent Night or sleep? I'll just give you a moment to chime in. And while I'm waiting for that, I do have two other actual sleep tips that I share with my clients. And that is, if you haven't already, I mean, you can't do any kind of research on improving the quality of your sleep without already hearing about the importance of, you know, putting devices away, right? About 30 minutes before you try to sleep. The importance of a nighttime sleep practice or a wind down ritual. But here's two other really important things. Cold temperature. You always want to reduce the temperature in your home, or at least the temperature in your bedroom. Our body does so much better. It gets deeper quality sleep when our body is actually warm, our feet are warm, and our head is cool. And so make sure your feet are warm, your head is cool. Lower the temperature in your bedroom, even just a couple degrees, and see if that doesn't make a difference. Also, there is so much truth to making sure, see, our melatonin is to be secreted when it's dark out. That's actually the way our body was created, to react to the darkness. And so for those of you that are not sleeping where it's completely dark, or maybe you've got a work schedule that doesn't allow that, maybe that's reversed, your AM and PMs, get a very good quality sleep mask that covers every area. Make sure it's got a little bit of weight to it. That will help as well. So keep your head cool, your feet warm, keep it very dark, keep the room a little cooler, put devices away at least 30 minutes prior to sleep. Don't sleep with a phone by your bed. If you use an alarm, keep the alarm, it's actually a good little tip to keep the phone outside your, either on the floor or across the room, or even if, you know, even outside the room on the other side of, you know, outside the door, forces you to get up. So, all right. Good morning. Good morning. Any placement for those who cannot fall asleep? Well, Donna, that's an important thing to, I would say if they're, let me just think about that, because this will help people actually, it'll start to calm their nervous system, but it's really about what they're doing prior to bed. So those other little tips that I was mentioning will be far better to help them fall asleep. Most people, if you really have them do an inventory of what their life is like before bed, they've got too much chaos going on right before sleep. Or if they sleep with a pet, I mean, I love pets too, but people that have issues sleeping, if there's a pet in the bed, that pet can actually, the pet's energy, the pet can actually disturb it. If the bedroom is really, really cluttered, including under the bed, that will disturb sleep energy. There is so much truth to making sure people get themselves set up for proper sleep ahead of time. A wonderful bath before bed, Donna, can be, you know, and I know you're helping people, you know, in your practice, but salt, a deep natural salt bath, you know, natural salt, not all the stuff with all the chemicals, good Epsom salt with maybe some really good quality lavender oil or rose extract oil. But we also need to make sure that they're not drinking alcohol right before bed. They don't eat heavy before bed. These are all, so people that have issues falling asleep, usually the practices, we have to address what they're doing about an hour to 2 hours before sleep. So those are a couple things that I think that if you look at that and help people with that, that can be certainly helpful. But you also could recommend an Eon patch, maybe about an hour before bed, because Eon at the back of the neck will really help to, you know, relax that nervous system. So you're so welcome. Cindy, do you know how long it takes for people to get out of the body, the bad habits of waking up in the evening? Yes, I can't speak for everybody, you know. So the question Cindy's asking is, how long does someone have to use the patching before they actually start changing, you know, the waking up? It can be the first night, Cindy. It can be the first night, but it can also take up to 5 to 7 days. Our role is to encourage people not to give up, because sleep just like any other habit, needs to be corrected. If it's not a good habit, it needs to be corrected. And what you really want to do is make sure people do not come to the conclusion that the silent night patches don't work, that the light therapy doesn't work if they don't fall asleep or stay asleep or have a good night's sleep, you know, night one. It can take a couple nights. It also can be a matter. Never let someone say the silent patches don't work unless they've tried all acupoints featured in the brochure. And, you know, there's those five, have them try all five, because, or the heart one, if there is those heart issues. Never let people come to the conclusion this doesn't work. It works. They just have to find, you know, again, 50% of the people will have a better result wearing a patch on the upper body and the other 50% on the lower body. And again, these are tips that unless you know, you wouldn't know. So what else do you have here? So, oh, absolutely. All right. Anything else that I can answer for you in the area of sleep, specifically the silent night? All right. I will resume Patch School on Tuesday, and we're going to finish up all next week then, Tuesday through Friday. And have a wonderful, wonderful weekend, everyone. Bye.